Don't forget the nursery's open this morning, and it's the, to my right, it's the, somewhere over there. I think it's the second door on the left there, you'll find the nursery. And you can take a kid in there today, and they will take care of it, and make sure that it's took care of. So don't forget that, we're trying to get that built up. Also, Wednesday night at 6:30, Bob Clark will be preaching for us Wednesday night. So don't forget that, remember it. Also, we had a great time Friday night if, painting. David C. had them up there. Look how pretty. Aren't they pretty? Mine is right here on the ball. It says, welcome. See, David's got a point to it. By the hell out. Don't you think I did a good job? Who did mine? Sydney did mine. And actually had to do a little bit of it too, so. But it looks pretty nice. Good fellowship. It was a good time. We had a real good time together Friday night. I thank them for getting that together. All that proceeds goes to BBS, and it made $330. And that's great. I'm telling you. Good time together. Also, the blessing box that's out in the hallway, that out in the foyer, is for Ramsey, Aaron Fields, and that's Alyssa and John's baby girl that's going to be coming pretty soon, real soon. So be sure you've got 1 week, so make sure you get your gift in there. It's a girl, make sure you get something for a girl. Get all of your frilly dresses. And I just love the little frilly dresses. So don't forget that. On May the 9th, we're going to have another state dinner. And it's at the Fellowship Hall, being at 6 o'clock. We will not be having church on that Wednesday night. And we need you to sign up with the sign-up sheet. Debbie's got a sign-up sheet out in the foyer and on the bulletin board. So you need to fill that out, what you can bring. She's got it all marked down there. So be sure and make sure you sign that and get your name on that to what you can bring. So if you don't, then me and Betty will be cooking. So be sure and help us out on that. So it's May the 9th, and remember that. Also May the 18th and 19th, the youth are having a youth rally down at the gazebo here in Cumberland. And Michael Clark's going to be preaching that night. They're going to have, I think, Little Leatherwood Church is going to be doing some drama. They're going to have different youth doing things. So be sure and be a part of this and come out. It's on a Friday and Saturday night at 7 o'clock. And this is an outreach from our church that we can get out in the community. So remember that and be sure and get that. Be there. And also they're selling BBS t-shirts, $10 each, and you see Ashley for that. And BBS is July the 16th through the 20th. There's a sign-up sheet out in the lobby. So make sure you sign that sheet up that you can help them their Vacation Bible School. Let's rejoice as our brothers come to take their Bible offerings.
We'll be having youth service tonight at 6 o'clock, and Brandon Pearson will be speaking tonight, so you don't want to miss it. Come out 6 o'clock. Even if you're an adult, you want to come to youth service, be here tonight. We've been having some awesome youth services. Also, in October, I know I've mentioned this one other time, but we're going to be having a joint 20-year celebration, because this is my mom and dad's 20th year as pastors. We'll be having that October the 17th through the 21st. And David C. made up a save the date on Facebook. If you all care, make sure you share that so we can get the word out, because we want to make sure, we want to get people that have been former members of the church that have had to move off. We'd love to have them come back for that. and that'll be on October the 17th through the 21st, so make sure you put that on your calendar.
Okay, we'll do our declaration. As we bring in today's tithes, offerings, and over and above giving, we are believing the Lord for a supernatural release of God's favor over every area of our lives. Jobs and better jobs, checks in the mail, inheritances, secure investments, scholarships, creative ideals, finding money, healing for our spirit, soul, and body, deliverance to the captive, salvation to the lost, and an outpouring of the Holy Ghost. We are blessed and we will be a blessing to others in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Give Jesus a hand.
John, y'all come get ready to sing. We're going to sing the Lighthouse.
Our idol promise this morning comes out of 1 John chapter 2, verse 25. Says, and this is the promise that he has promised us, even in eternal life. You know, that was one, I think that's one of the major promises that God has given us, that we have got eternal life through Jesus Christ. You know, sometimes this life that we're living right now gives us a whole lot of problems, a whole lot of things that come from our own choices, some of them not. That we could really get knocked down in this life. The Bible tells us that in this life only we have hope in Jesus. We have all been most miserable, but we have got a promise. We have got a promise of eternal life. You know, the Bible says the answer from this body is to be present with the Lord. When you just pass on, you just move on. You know, this life is over, we got a brand new one coming. Yeah. And this other one is a whole lot better than this one is. So we need to make plans right now.
Yeah.
You know, to be able to make that move. To make that transition. Now, what we have to do, we've got to trust Jesus Christ. It says, you know, if you'll confess your sins, he's faithful and just, forgive us of our sins, cleanse us from all unrighteousness. You know, if you'll believe and be baptized, you shall be saved. Made it real simple. He's done everything for us. We just got to claim it. We've got to trust him. We've got to follow him. We have eternal life. Who's got a prayer request this morning? Yeah, I'm real good. Still remember my cousin Andy.
Remember the Elton family, you remember the Elton family?
Yes. Just remember Adam Hill. I don't know if y'all remember him or not. Adam used to go to church here, and they've been diagnosed with a real aggressive leukemia. And Adam, he's the lead singer for one of the groups and things, and I say he's one of ours. So just remember him. Just keep him in prayer.
Remember Matt Shelton. Yeah. Jim Bush.
Yes. Jim Bush. And Vince Bush.
And the Ronnie Gillum's family from everything.
Yeah. We have a lot of things to pray about. Y'all spoke with request.
There was a 3-year-old in St. Cotto on a friend last night.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Just remember that 11-year-old that was babysitting. You know, just think about all the guilt, the harm that child. So if you have prayer requests, if you have spoken requests, take that name before. There's so many I can't even remember. I don't remember about that long. But if you call that name before the Lord, that's special. That's special. He wants to hear from us. This is prayer. Most kind of not just every father. We come before you right now. Not so many spoken requests, so many unspoken requests. Father, your people, your children have needs. And Father, we know that you want to fill those needs. God, we ask you that you would just move upon each and every spoken request, Father, every unspoken request. God, that you would heal, and you would deliver, Father, and you would lift them up, Father, and you would provide strength. God, you would provide healing, Lord, that Jesus has already paid for. We claim that healing for those that need the healing, Father. We know, God, that you have provisions stored up for us, that you just release those provisions for those that need them, Father. God, we claim your promises, Father. that you've already made for us. God, we ask you that you would just bless each and every request, God. Move upon your people, Father. Bless our nation. Bless our leaders of our nation. Bless our communities, Father. God, we pray for the peace of Israel. Be with your people, Father. And bless each and every one here. God, we ask you to bless this offering that God received. Let your people, Father, we give you our praise. We thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
There's a lot
I'm
sick, and y'all been praying, and I appreciate it. And, but I made a decision this morning that I was going to come up here and thank God for being able to come here this morning. And y'all are my brothers and sisters in Christ. And if you don't mind, I'd like to invite you to come up here and stand with me. And let praise the Lord with me. Because in my mind, I'm not sick with epilepsy. Y'all, I'm already healed. If something happens to me and it's my time, I'm going home. I know my mom worries about me a ton. But that's all that I think about is there's no need to worry. It's, we're going home. If something happens, we're going home. So let's not just sit down and clap, stand for a song. Let's get up here and really thank Him and worship Him for the God He is.
Yes.
I don't have to.
How was your reading? You know, David was chosen. He was anointed. He was anointed. He was anointed. He was anointed. By Samuel he came. He was chosen. You understand that? He was chosen. Just like you, you were chosen for a teacher thing. And you're chosen by the same God that chose David. So his brothers were out. And they were fighting. They were fighting foot size, but they were fighting the wrong way.
Come on.
He was fighting the wrong way. So David goes up to the battle. He goes up to take on some bread and water and some cheese to help him out. And he sees this Philistine. The greatest hour of your life, right? The life was the greatest thing that happened to David. Think about this. He was the greatest thing that happened to David. Why do I say that? Because you continue to have a Goliath problem, you don't get it. Chapter 17, verse 8. He chose by his wisdom.
the battle that is waging against you if you don't choose to take the spiritual word and have it and let God. Remember the stone that the stone is what killed. The stone is what killed. And he threw it in fact. He threw it in fact. Why is it so hard to believe that Bible? Why is it so hard? Every one of you come into church today. You walked in, and what did you do? You said, just like this. You said, what's sitting there? Did you get under this and look? Is this going to work? This will work. Every one of you got in your heart this morning. You did your key in the mission. And you turned up because you knew it was going to start. Why did you know it was going to start? Because some mechanic can put it together, some engineer designed it, and you just get in it. 3,000 pound vehicle. You go 7 seats. Something about 7. Go 50 miles an hour down the road. Around the corner, and you're trying to win. Did you take the one cover off? Check the nut. Be sure that the spline was proper. And did you verify all that was going to work before you tried to come to church and it brought an opinion that you didn't expect? Did you?
Start believing.
it is that shall tread down our enemies. It is not you, and it's not the enemy that shall tread down. And she was praying out what is in you and what is in it. Was that what you said? You don't understand it. So when we sing, Chris hit me out here in the park, he just come up and we started the Lord just. I mean, it's amazing. I wasn't expecting that. It's about every Sunday, right? You know, I don't know how it is. But boom, there's the Lord. Right? I wasn't expecting. Just like, you know, I just want to encourage you to believe. To believe. To use the same kind of faith that you use when you get in your car. There's no difference. Actually, I went on this. Okay, I'll take my chances with what you're getting. You know, I'll take my chances with that. But think about faith. Think about it for a minute. That's all we need is faith. Yeah. And without faith, it's impossible to please God. But you must have faith and you exercise faith. So why is it so hard for us to believe this? But yet the very thing we pamper all the time, which is our body and our flesh, we just by blind faith, we get on the roller coaster. I mean, we do all kinds of crazy stuff, ridiculous things by faith, but yet, well, I better not raise my hands. I better not pray. I better not make an issue. You know, you have to be good enough to raise your hand. What makes you acceptable is the price that Jesus Christ paid. And you can too. You can too. So don't be cheated. Don't let your blessing be ripped from you because of God. Don't do that. You know that is chosen and pulled you. It's the same that went out. And so Samuel said, anoint him. Him, the little guy. The one that his dad didn't even consider. He had him out. He said, you got your son's brain. Nobody can rise up. Seven boys. Seven. And he goes down through. No. Comes back. He says, Jesse, you got any boys? Well, there's this little scrapper up there, you know, good the goat thing, the sheep thing. Stand for it. See? God looks inside. Yeah. Look at the outside. He doesn't care what the outside looks like. Because when he begins to shake and go inside, the outside takes on the whole thing. It's the same God that become a man, took his our substitute for God what? So loved the world. He so loved the world. He so loved the world. So loved that he became. He became man and took our place. You stoned your life because hell. See, that's a problem. That's another problem. I'm shutting up. The one more problem is we use the stone and we hit and kill the giant. We hit him in the head, right? The stone, he falls, but we don't finish the job. We go get him back up and say, oh, I'm sorry. We got to cut his head off. And that's what you have to do. God does his part. Then you've got to buy faith to walk in. Think about it. That lets that stone boom. Glad and stand, thus springs. That's my champion. That's it. I was at him. He goes up and he uses the tool of problem to decapitate, right? And when you cut the head off, the body dies, right? You got it. It's not enough to quit this. It's not enough to stop that. You've got to turn. And go this way. Yes. And don't look back.
That's right.
Don't look back. Go. go. Walk in, because it is Him.
Right.
It's Jesus Christ that remembered you, that took you, and put His name on you, so that you would walk victorious.
Yeah.
That's all you got to do. By faith, believe. Think about that. It's all by faith. Your whole entire life is by faith, and you never measure up. But understand, you don't have to measure up. You don't have to measure up. Remember what Peter said? Well, you know, he was, what I got to do for you? Seven times, right? You know, he did not seven times say, you know, and they fed on me 409, and if they go 491, you're going to pay for him. That's a figure of speech, and all that means is, no matter what, you got to forgive. Because we're imperfect. But when we sang that song, His name is perfect. His being is perfect. Everything about Him is perfect.
Yeah.
Everything about Him is just. Everything about Him is pure. Everything about Him is everything we're not. We don't have to, because He's in you. See that? You see how that works? Then you get that. Please get hold of that. Please get hold of it, because it's through Him. It's in Him, through Him, and by Him that we live, we move, and we have our being. Every breath we take is because of Him.
Yes.
And when we get that in us, we're much more than conquerors. Much more than conquerors. Then you walk where God sees you. See, when God chose David, He didn't see David as the little boy grabbing the bird and lying in the river. He seen him as the king of Israel. He seen him as through his loins, he was going to produce the Messiah.
Yeah.
No. know. Exactly. Of course, he said, sometimes I am going to that place. But Paul says, for me, that is daddy, and I understand what that means. I know what that means. He wanted to get out of here. But it was a very bad shape. Started to my own shape, right? Because he meant it. He went down to breathe, work out, and we can turn her away. So, then we did all this. The Lord just is in me, in my spirit, really. Read that about David and understand, you're no different. You're chosen. The world doesn't expect you. The world doesn't expect you because, you know, you don't look like Billy Graham man. But Billy Graham, you look like Billy Graham when you started. Come on. You know, Brother Brock, you look like Brother Brock when he started. But he started. Okay? You're started. You're started, okay? You're started. That's how you're going to do is take off. So, think of what I said. I'm sure we'll play another song. And if you've got anything that's standing, if there's a Goliath problem standing between you and this altar, or you and Christ, or you and that thing is beating you and telling you that you're not going to do that, okay, your stone is in your swing. And it's going to be up to you to run that labor man directly toward that problem and launch it, let it go. Because it's God that you're turning loose. It's God that you're turning loose. It's the Spirit of God that you're swinging. It's not you. But if you don't swing it, it don't go. Because you're the vehicle. It's by faith, through faith, and only faith. But all you have to do is move. If you'll move him, and if you know, God is a gentle person, gentle man. If you don't want to come, use Mr. West. And you can pack that same problem that you brought in this church house right back out in yours. And it gains weight because you're going to feed it because it's going to wear your head out all week. I told you, you heard that, your heart's beating like a drum, and we're seeing the little problem in your life that you never was racing through your head, and you carry it back out the door. That's a pill. God's pill. All you got to do is come. That is all you have to do is come. By faith, stand in and come and pray. Acknowledges to God that you're fervent and you believe in what He's done. You have not faith when you stand up in front of this hour. It's no show. It's a show of God. It's not a show. And you're showing God that you have faith, that He's able to do that and send you. And we do that by acknowledging Him and coming forward. That's an act of faith. That's the same act of faith that you chose to do when you come in here. And you mind me set on these pews. And you expect this pew to collect you and support you. When you come to our, you're showing God that you expect Him to collect you and to support you in all that you do because He loves you and He chose you for the purpose. But until you move accordingly, He, the Bible tells us, is a lamp to her feet and a light to her path. And what's that mean? It didn't say it's that spot on the third shoulder by the mouth. You know what's a lamp to my feet and a light to my path? There's one step. And then I say the next one. I say the next one. I can't look. See, that's the thing about faith. But I don't know if I've been there. God's going to take care of me. Because He promised. And He can't come back on His word. He can't because He's it's who He is. He holds His word above His name. And we just told you how great His name was. We sang a song about His name. It's why He lives higher than His name. Why do you think He chose Israel as He was saved? Why do you think that's so? Because He said He would. Why do you say He is?
He's gave you an opportunity this morning, so you need to come. If you're here and you don't know Jesus, you need to find him. You need to find him because he's a friend that sticks closer than a brother. And he's going to be there for your trials. He's going to be there for you. So it's your opportunity right now. Find Jesus. Come to this altar this morning. Come to this altar. Find him today.
Thank you.
word today. Amen. Yes. I think Dr. Charles had an anointing.
Yes.
How many knows your, what to say, I already forgot. Chosen and anointed.
Yes.
Really ain't raising your hand. How many knows you're chosen and anointed?
Yes.
Brandon, did you raise your hand? Great when God just comes in and takes charge of the service. And you feel like you've been in church today. If you haven't, it's your own fault. Look at the person next to you and say, it's your fault if you don't feel like you've been in church. And we've had church today. Amen. Let's stand. And I'm sure you remember all the announcements. Thank God for showing up. Thank David for obeying Him. Thank you for listening. Never let the enemy tell you that you're not worthy. I mean, we know you're not, right? We know that no matter what we can do, it wouldn't be good enough to earn what He's given us free. All because of His love. Commended His love toward us while we were dead sinners. Christ died for us. Father, we thank you today. We thank you that we finally come to the place that we can't earn what you have freely given us. God, we want to enjoy what you have blessed us with. You have put us here on this planet to enjoy life, not to try to live up to a code, not to try to live up to a certain amount of commandments, but to love you and to know you. God, that's your plan, that we'll come to know you and all of your benefits and all the blessings. And Lord, we want to walk after you. We don't want anything that pulls to the left or the right. We want to focus completely on you. We thank you, God. We want to know you greater. Thank you, God, that you have cleansed us and washed us by your blood. That we can leave this place rejoicing in you. I pray every person in this room, whatever we're facing, you're aware of. You know where we are. You're not wringing your hands and thinking, what am I going to do? You have it in control. You're on the throne. We thank you for it in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Shake hands.